Air. With lithium-powered brushless tools becoming cheaper and more powerful than ever, pneumatic tools are slowly becoming obsolete. But in my garage, I still have uses for air. I track my cars, so I'm airing my tires up and down often, and the Midwest temperature swings mean I even have to do this for my daily drivers too. My bend pack lift uses air locks, and the bend pack rolling bridge jacks that I have are also air powered. I also have some air tools, but I don't use those too often anymore. To keep this brief, I've decided to split this into several videos since I have a lot to cover. In this video, I'll cover my current setup, what my plan is, and what I've purchased and accomplished so far. After some research, I decided to go with rapidair's garage kit. It comes with 100 feet of PEX-like tubing, a cutting tool, and a handful of push-to-connect elbows and fittings, a manifold, and two outlets. Doesn't come with any quick couplers, and most people end up buying some extra elbows and fittings if they want to add some inline filters and water separators and such. It's probably possible to add that sort of thing without extra fittings, but I think most people will likely need them. I bought a bunch of extras to make life easier on myself. My end goal is to have everything hardwired to the compressor. That includes two hose reels, the lift's air locks, an outlet at the workbench. I'd also like a permanently mounted blowgun with its own regulator hanging from a coil hose from the ceiling right above my workbench. If I have enough tubing left over, I'd also like to run an outlet over to the front of the garage between the two garage doors. Since the kit comes with two outlets, I might as well. Compressors run when the pressure goes below a certain value, so if you permanently connect your compressor to your garage air system and it gets a leak overnight, your compressor might run all night and can burn your house down as they put out a ton of heat. Some compressors have heat and duty cycle limits to prevent that sort of thing, but not all of them do. To remove the human element from this, I'm going to design a system to automate that. Push a button to get time, push it again to get more time. When time runs out, it cuts power to the compressor and disconnects it from the air system with a solenoid. Before time's out, it'll also give you warning beeps so you get a chance to add more time before it shuts off. Same deal if you turn the lights in the garage off, it'll have a light sensor and it'll shut the system off regardless of how much time you have left. Safety first. I have lots to talk about with this setup, so I'll probably save that for its own video. I also plan on putting ball valves at the start of each leg of the air system. So for example, if the hose reel gets a leak, I can close it off and isolate it from the rest of the system with the ball valve, and I'll still be able to operate the air locks on my lift to get the car off the lift. Ball valves are pretty cheap, so I couldn't think of any reason not to do this. I've spent about a decade or more manually unwinding my air hose from my compressor and then dragging it around the garage, and it's been annoying, and I can't believe I've waited this long to remedy that annoyance. I bought two clutch brand hose reels from Northern Tool. The mounting plates don't bridge the gap between two studs, so I have to use 2x4s to accomplish this and then use really long lag bolts to get through them. The reels are extremely heavy, so it's difficult if not nearly impossible to do it alone, so definitely get some help from a friend. I plumbed them together with a T-fitting and then down to where the compressor is. I don't have a manifold set up yet, so currently I just have to manually connect it with a quick coupler to the compressor. If I need to use a lift, I basically have to disconnect it from that and then manually connect the quick coupler to the one on the air locks. And it works, but you know, it's annoying and it creates a tripping hazard. I'm currently really busy, so my plan is to do just enough to get this to a happy medium. I'd like to add another T and run a line down to the air locks. The air locks need about 75 to 90 PSI according to Benpack, but no more than 125 PSI. So I'll give this line its own regulator just to make sure that it stays in a happy range. That'll mean I can use both the hose reels and the air locks without disconnecting and reconnecting anything. It'll also get rid of that tripping hazard. I'd also like to get a quick manifold set up, but in place of the solenoids, I'll just use ball valves for now. I'll open the valve between the compressor tank and the air lines, and then whenever I'm done, I'll close it. In the future, a microcontroller that I'll program will control this automatically via the solenoids. I'll also have one that bleeds air out of the lines, and that'll help draw moisture out of the lines as well. I'll direct this air through a silencer so it won't be as loud as it currently is when I disconnect the line from the compressor and the pressure just dumps out all at once. Well, I think it's enough rambling for one video. The next video will be the action. We'll get the air locks hardwired through its own regulator and tee into the current line for the hose reels. We'll also get a manifold set up so I don't have to disconnect the compressor each time I use it. See you in the next one.